So today I'm going to show you how to make a shader box. So for that I am using this kind of the wooden frame which I bought it from the Michaels. You can also make your customized shader box from the carpenter, and right now I'm just applying a white acrylic paint on the base of the shader box. There is one giveaway running on my YouTube channel, so you may get chance to win a $50 of a craft supplies. Check the description box for all the details. If you wanna participate in my giveaway, then just check the description box and make sure that you subscribe to my YouTube channel, because in this Valentine's season I am going to upload a lots of videos about the Valentine's Day. And if you are planning to recreate any of my DIY, then make sure you tag me on Instagram or Facebook so I can give you shout out on my Instagram stories. Here is my Instagram. If you wanna follow me on my Instagram, then go and check it out. After that, I am using this distress ink pad, and I am going to apply this distress ink on the edges of my shadow box. So it's gonna create some vintage effect on it, and I'm just randomly apply this distress ink on the edges of my shadow box, also inside the shadow box, so it's gonna create some depth on it. After that I'm going to use this printed paper, and I'm just distressing the edge of my printed paper, and then I'm going to apply the distress ink on the edges of my paper. And then I'm going to stick this printed paper inside the shadow box like this. After that I'm going to use this black and white photographs, and I already applied the printed paper on the backside of the photographs to create some nice border. And after that I'm going to stick this photograph with the help of cardboard tape, so it's gonna create some heights. You can also use a two-sided tape to stick these photographs. After that I am going to decorate this shadow box with the help of miniatures, stickers, flowers, tags, ribbons, papers. You just need to decorate your shadow box with the whatever you have. It's not necessary to use same exact material which I am using in my project. You can easily get this kind of the miniature from the gift shop, and some of the stuff you can easily find it from the stationery store or a craft store. There isn't any specific rule to decorate the shadow box. You can decorate this shadow box by your choice. I'm just randomly putting all this stuff where I feel that it gonna looks nice. And I bought all this stuff from the Michaels, and I spent around $25 to $30 on it. So in this way my shadow box is ready. I hope you like it. If you like this video, then make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't it already, because I'm going to post videos about DIY, art, craft, decoration and many more things. And I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye.